You should give the same respect to this hallowed site where 165 people lost their lives. It's no different. Just give the respect that is deserved.
New tonight, a judge grants a restraining order halting construction on a new development on the site where the Beverly Hills Supper Club once stood. Now, the $65 million project is planned to include a senior living facility, an apartment complex, and single-family homes, as well as a park.
Tonight, with those plans on pause, WCPO 9 News reporter Jake Ryle is sharing the request from family of the fire victims when it comes to a proper memorial.
Well, folks I talked to said it loud and clear. They're not against the development at the top of this hill here in Southgate. Instead, what they're wanting are restrictions to honor hallowed ground where so many lost their lives.
Bring up the words Beverly Hills Supper Club to folks like Leslie Henry.
Very vividly. I remember it all.
Her mom died in the fire 43 years ago.
I feel like if a building was built on top of that cabaret room right now, I feel like somebody would be building a building over my mom's ashes.
And that's at the center of Tuesday's court ruling.
If this was a Indian burial ground, there would be no work there whatsoever. My clients are just asking the same respect be given to a hallowed ground where they lost family members and where they believe that their family members' bodies may in part still be.
Stephen Meggerly is representing the victims' family members and the group Beverly Hills Supper Club Respect the Dead. They're up against the developer, Ashley Commercial Group, Southgate City Council members, and the mayor.
Ashley, we discovered during our negotiations, has never conducted a survey, a professional survey, meets and bounds survey, to determine the actual footprint of where the supper club sat. So that's problematic.
He's asking for a professional survey to mark the layout of the supper club, now overtaken by nature.
Not knowing where the cabaret room was, it was a little bit disingenuous.
Meggerly is bringing survivors' voices to the table, requesting a memorial fountain on the site and to not develop on the land of the former supper club building, all to allow survivors, family members, and first responders a chance for closure decades later.
A lot of people find this to be hallowed ground.
In Southgate, Jake Ryle, WCPO 9 News.
We have reached out to Ashley Builders Group about that restraining order. The company says it believes the order is based on statements made by the plaintiff's attorney that are, they say, without merit. And the company expects the injunction to be lifted when it presents its side of things in court.